What's up for June? Saturn at its best, plus good views of Mars, Jupiter, and Jupiter's moons continue from dusk to dawn. Hello and welcome. I'm Jane Houston Jones at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. You don't have to stay up late to see Jupiter, Mars, and Saturn this month because they're all visible soon after sunset. Jupiter is the brightest of the three, visible in the western sky all evening. The four Galilean moons are easily visible in binoculars or telescopes. If you think you're seeing five moons on June 10th, you're not. One of them is a distant star in the constellation Leo. For telescope viewers, the time near Mars's closest approach to Earth, May 30th this year, is the best time to try to see the two moons of Mars, Phobos and Deimos. It takes patience, very steady skies, and good charts. I saw both moons in my telescope at Mars opposition in 2003. Mars is still large and bright in early June, but it fades as speedy Earth, in its shorter orbit around the Sun, passes it. Saturn has been close to Mars recently. This month, Saturn reaches opposition, when Saturn, Earth, and the Sun are in a straight line, with Earth in the middle, providing the best and closest views of the ringed beauty and several of its moons. You'll be able to make out cloud bands in delicate shades of cream and butterscotch. They're fainter than the bands of Jupiter. Through a telescope, you'll see Saturn's rings tilted about as wide as they get, 26 degrees. You'll also have a ringside view of the Cassini division, discovered by Giovanni Domenico Cassini, the namesake of NASA's Cassini spacecraft, orbiting Saturn since 2004 and continuing through September 2017. When you look at Saturn through a telescope, you can't help but see several of its four brightest moons, and maybe more. If you see just one, that's Titan, 50% larger than our own moon. A telescope can also reveal more moons, like Saturn's two-colored moon, Iapetus. It takes 3 months to orbit Saturn, and it's fairly easy to see. There's a bright comet visible this month, Comet Pan-STARRS. It's best seen from the southern hemisphere, but it's also visible in the U.S., low in the morning sky. Comet Pan-STARRS can be seen through a telescope near the beautiful Helix Nebula on June 4th, but it's visible all month. You can catch up on current missions to comets, Jupiter, and Saturn, and all of NASA's other missions at www.nasa.gov. That's all for this month. I'm Jane Houston Jones.